nice Art Nouveau style house, apartment building in Moscow. Actually, they say Moscow. This is where we're going for lunch. Statues out front. Interior of this restaurant. Oh my. Quite
so
elaborate.
Back here, your lunch is in this hall.
It was an orphanage. And then for 50 years, the Institute of the Girls of the Noble Birth. So where we are now, it was a beautiful garden where these girls like to walk. It was a garden here. After the revolution in 1917, it belonged to military offices. For example, here there was a military, a chemical military academy. In 1997, famous sculptor, painter, a very talented person whose name was Siritidi, he decided to restore this building. He made the glass roof and he called this place the apple, green apple. Why apple? Because apple, inside the apples, there are seeds. Seeds of future life, future generation. And from the biblical point of view, what is apple?
This is a big apple.
And that's what apple is. Later you can go inside. See there some erotic scenes from, you know, like Kama Sutra, right? And in the center you will see the Adam and Eve. They are still in the paradise. Creation of the world, creation of Adam and Eve. It's just here. On this side, there are evangelist scenes. This is Brodsky. Have you heard about him? He's Russian and American writer and poet. Look how different he is. One side is like he's a Nobel winner, prize. He got the prize, Nobel Prize, for his beautiful poems. And the other, like he's in the prison. Famous Russian poet, like he was, and he will be the best poet of our time, Sinka Vysotsky by name. I want to tell you, in the time of Leonid Brezhnev, he was forbidden. It was not allowed to listen to his songs. Okay, now let me explain to you, who are these? To the right, like a monk. You know who is that? Solzhenitsyn, you know this name?
Yes.
He wrote his book about Gulag. Mm-hmm. Yes, about the prison, Solzhenitsyn. In the center, this is the famous cellist. Maybe you know this name, Rostropovich. To the left, Shostakovich, famous composer. He composed his music, the Seventh Symphony, during the siege of Leningrad, during the Second World War. It's the only sculpture which is hollow inside. All the rest is like peace, but this is hollow inside. This is Alexander II, liberator. He liberated Russia from serfdom in 1861. The second, his wife Alexander, four daughters and son Alexei. Why did he, what's happened? You know that the good wife, because this is such a tragic moment between the life and death. At the moment they are alive, but in a minute they will be killed. Such a moment between life and death. This is famous painting, my image, which is made painted black square. Everybody ask about this sculpture. It's like love. You see the ring, it's love. But do you see the man is with the speed here, peace, a very strange thing reminding us a poem. This is AIDS virus. AIDS virus. He was a very wise man. He was, by the way, very big, very strong man. When he was at the power, Russia did not wage wars with other countries. You know what? He was so really so wise, but he died after 13 years when he was. Elizabeth was the daughter of Peter the Great. He had 10 kids. But the most beautiful was Elizabeth, with her blonde hair, with her rosy cheek, with her blue eyes. That's Elizabeth. She was the true daughter of Peter the Great. He continued his policy. So this is... next to her, there is the daughter of Nicholas the First, who was a very smart lady and who was at the head of the Academy of Art.
This is Peter the Great. Nicholas II's mother, Maria.
She was the only one to whom some people helped to run away to Denmark. Who really loved art and who did a lot for our country. Though she was a German from Germany, you know how people called her Mother Russia.
Catherine the Great.
She loved Russia. She wore all this Russian. Oh, by the way, like today you saw Julia in this national dress. She loved to wear these national dresses.
This is rather erotic art. Similar to what you might find in an Indian temple. That's for a wedding party later today. Here's St. George again, slaying the dragon. And another version